Now let's talk about the case where we have many masses and they are rotating in different planes. So this is how you'll have, forget about B1 and B2 for the moment. So you have M1, M2, M3 and M4 as four disturbing masses which are rotating in different planes. So when you look at it from this side, this is how you will see them at different orientations, and we assume that this mass M1 is horizontal. So we have one reference, you can say line, from where we measure the orientations of the rest of the three masses. Now to balance this system, let us say we are putting two balancing masses, B1 and B2. The first balancing mass is in between M1 and M2, and the second one is in between M3 and M4. We don't know B1, we don't know B2. So in one system, we have two unknowns. How do we solve them? To solve such a system, we have to assume one of these two unknown masses as the reference mass. Or I would say this plane or that plane as a reference plane. Okay, so it's a convention that we always start the origin from the left hand side. So we'll assume this plane as a reference plane. So I'll mark this as RB. So all the distances are measured from this point. Let us say this point is A. Alright, so the distance of plane 1 is L1, the distance of the RP from plane 2 is L2, then you have L3, L4 and L5. Okay, so there are two things in which that we have to do in this particular analysis. We have to balance the couple and we have to balance the forces. Okay, so we'll draw a couple polygon and a force polygon. Okay, so how do we do that? Because we don't know either B1 and B2. So by taking this as a reference plane, so we'll find out the couples or the moments about this point. So the moment due to this force, or force at B1, that is M, or you can say B1 omega square small b1, that's the centrifugal force, the moment due to that force would be zero, because we are finding out moments at this point. So one quantity becomes zero. Okay, and from that we can find out B2. So we'll start with the couple, polygon. So we'll draw the forces. So this is, let us say F1, that is F2, this is F3, and this is F4. Right, so the couple would be force into L1, force into L2, force into L3, and so on. Okay, so I would say, because this is a negative distance, because it is towards the left of the origin, so the couple due to this force would be a negative couple. So we'll give it a reference point O, and I'll draw a line like this, which will give me, let us say, C1. Okay, now from this point, I'll draw a couple in direction of C2. So you'll have this. So this is C2. Okay, and this angle from the horizontal is theta 1. Then from C2, we'll draw C3. So you draw a dotted line as the reference, and this is what you get, C3. And this is theta 2. Okay, then from that orientation, we draw C4. Okay, and that would be like this, isn't it? So this is C4. So all this happens by taking a suitable scale. So this is theta 3. Okay, so we have done with the known couples. There is one couple which is left due to this mass, B2. Okay, so you will have to join O and this point. This one. And that can be in the opposite sense. So this becomes CB2. All right. So with the help of this length, okay, so CB2 as per a scale will be some value converted to the couple, isn't it? And this would be equal to B2 into small b2 into the distance, that is L4. With this particular formula or this particular equation, I will be able to calculate b2. Because with this measurement, with the scale, we'll get CB2. B2 is known to us, small b2, the radius of rotation of this balancing mass, and L4 is also known to us. With that, we find out b2. So, out of the two unknowns, one is calculated with the help of a couple polygon. Okay, now we don't know, we don't need this reference plane. So, I can just remove it. Because now I'll make a force polygon. And before I do that, I also need the orientation of this. So, the orientation is, let us say, theta b. Okay, so from, if I have to draw it on that, okay, it would be somewhere over here. So this is b2 at small b2 radius, and the orientation would be theta b. Okay, so that is how you draw it. Now the orientation is done, now we'll draw the forces polygon. Okay, so the force would be like this, isn't it? With the help of this force polygon and b2 known to us, we can find out b1. Okay, let's start with it. You will have this as your starting point. F1 goes in that direction. Okay, F2 goes in theta 1 direction, like this. So this is F2. And this is theta 1. Okay, now you have your theta 3 at theta 2 angle. So this is theta F3 and this is theta 2. Everything is drawn to scale. So for a couple, you choose a scale. For a force diagram, also, you have to choose the scale. Then we draw this F4. So F4 is at theta 3, this is F4, okay, and then we draw this B2, so this would be, okay, this would be like this, this is FB2 and the angle is theta B. So the vector which is closing this force polygon would become FB1. Okay, and the orientation would be this, theta B1. Okay, let us say this is theta B2 to avoid confusion. So this is B2. Okay, and this orientation is theta B1. So with the help of the scale, you calculate FB1. So this FB1 has to be equal to capital B1 into small b1. There is no need of the length. So B1 is known to us. This we can calculate with the help of this diagram measurement and the scale that we take to draw all these forces. Okay. And from this we can calculate B1. So now we have also got B1. Okay. And then we can draw that on, we can draw this on this particular diagram, and that would be like this. So this is B1 at an orientation of theta B1. Okay, so these four disturbing forces or masses can be balanced by this configuration of masses in two different planes. Okay, so I hope you have understood this analysis of many masses rotating in different planes, which are balanced by two masses or multiple masses in different planes. Okay, now let's have a look at some basic examples on these topics.